In this cool project, you will learn how to create an AND logic gate on breadboard. How does it work? If I press either one of the switches, the LED is off. But if I press both of the switches at the same time, the LED turns on.
These are the components for this project. I'm using a breadboard, some breadboard connectors. You can also use some jumper wires, LED, 1 kilo ohm resistors, 2 10 kilo ohm resistors, 2 push button switches, 2 BC547 NPN transistors, and I'm going to use a 9 volt power supply. So let's get started. Let's place our transistors to the breadboard. Connect the collector pin of the first transistor to power. Now let's grab our 10 kilo ohm resistors and connect both of them to the base of the transistors and to a blank spot on breadboard. Also the second one. Second transistor goes to the base of the transistor and to a blank spot on breadboard. Now let's grab our push button switches and connect one of the pins to the other end of 10 kilo ohm resistor and the other pin goes to the power rail of the transistor of the breadboard. Connect the emitter of the first transistor to the collector pin of the second transistor. Let's grab our 1 kilo ohm resistor and connect one of them to the emitter pin of the first transistor and to ground. Here is my second 1 kilo ohm resistor. I'm going to connect it again to the emitter pin of the second transistor and to a blank spot on breadboard. The anode of the LED, the long pin, has to be connected to the other end of the 1 kilo ohm resistor and the cathode goes to the ground terminal of the breadboard. Now let's connect our power supply. And keep in mind that since we have used two negative rails of the breadboard, one here and one here, because of that we have to connect the ground terminals of the breadboard together. So now we are done with the circuit. Let's test it. Whenever I press one of the push button switches, the LED must not turn on. But whenever I press both of the switches, the LED turns on.
So here is how the circuit works. In order to turn on the LED, both of the transistors must conduct. The transistors are connected in series to each other, and it means that whenever one of the transistors are not conducting, hence current cannot flow through the LED and make it on. But what would happen if I press both of the switches at the same time? In this case, both of the transistors are conducting right now and current can flow through the LED. Can we make an OR gate just with this circuit? Yes, we can make it. And I will show you how we can get an OR gate from an AND gate. So the transistors are connected in series to each other. For an OR gate, we have to connect them in parallel to each other. So I'm going to disconnect my power supply. I'm going to remove this wire. And I'm going to connect them in parallel to each other. So emitter of the first transistor is going to be connected to the emitter of the first transistor. Can I make it? Yes. So right now the transistors are in parallel to each other, and what we need to do is to connect the second transistor, the collector of the second transistor, to power. So I'm gonna connect it just like the first transistor. The collector is going to be connected to power rail of the breadboard. Now let's test the circuit together. Right now we have an OR gate. The transistors are in parallel to each other. So whenever I press either one of these switches, the respective transistor is going to be conducted and the LED must turn on. Okay, I forgot to connect my power supply. So I have 9 volts coming through the circuit, and let's test it. So as you can see, our OR gate works perfectly. If I get a 1-0 in the out in the input, I will get a 1 on the output and the LED turns on.
How the circuit works? Whenever I connect my jumper wire to ground, I have a 0 on the input, and on the output I get 1. The LED is on. So if I do the opposite, what would happen? I connect my jumper wire to power, I get a 1 or high on the input, but on the output I get a 0, and because of that the LED is off. So watch this video to learn how the inverter logic gate works. These are the components for this project. I'm using a breadboard, jumper wire, LED, BC547 NPN transistor, 1 kΩ resistor, 220 Ω resistor to limit the current across the LED, and 100 Ω resistor. I'm gonna power the circuit using 5 volts. Let's place our transistor to the breadboard, our NPN transistor, and connect the emitter pin of the transistor to ground. Now let's grab our 1 kΩ resistor and connect it to the base of the transistor and a blank spot on breadboard. Connect the 100 Ω resistor to the collector pin of the transistor and to a blank spot on breadboard. The other end of the resistor, we are going to connect it to the power pin of the breadboard. Let us connect the 330 Ω resistor to the collector pin of the transistor and to a blank spot on breadboard. Now connect the anode pin of the LED, which is the longer pin, to the other end of the resistor and to ground. So anode is connected to the collector pin of the transistor, and cathode is connected to ground. Now let's grab the jumper wire and connect it to the 1 kΩ resistor. The under end of the jumper wire remains unconnected. And let's connect our 5 volt supply to the breadboard. So I'm going to connect the jumper wire to ground, indicating a 0 on the input. And as you can see, we get a 1 on the output. The LED indicates that we get a 1 or high at the output. Now if I do the opposite, I connect my jumper wire to power. In this case we get a 1 on the input, and on output we get a 0. The LED is off. When we have a 0 on the input, let's try it again. In this case, there is no current flowing through the resistor and into the base of the transistor, and it means that the transistor is in its off state. In this case, the transistor acts as an open switch between its collector and emitter. An open switch, it means that there is a high resistance between collector and emitter. Therefore, current prefers to flow or travel to the collector pin of the transistor through this resistor and finally to the LED, and it makes the LED to turn. But in the opposite, when we have a high in the input, there is enough current flowing through this base resistor and it reaches the base of the transistor and makes the transistor on. In this case, the transistor acts as a closed switch between its collector and emitter. And in this case, since there is a low resistance between collector-emitter junction, current prefers to travel through the collector and to the emitter, and since the emitter is connected to ground, and because of that, the red LED remains off. So that was the whole idea with inverter logic gate using a transistor and bunch of resistors. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed it, please give me a like and do not forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks and have a good day.